that's starting, go ahead and unload the truck. All right, got a couple bedside repairs and a full sheet of 16 gauge. I went out to my dad's shop last night, bought a sheet off of him. Man, I used to be able to buy that $49 for a 4x10 sheet of 16 gauge. It's $120, and that's my cost. That's right off the truck. Unreal. All right, let's get this truck started today. Gotta watch up in here because the gas door. I gotta stay in this area, but there is a bubble there, and of course the bottom side. Oh, got almost all that crease out of there when I did this the first time, but it's still not just right. A little bit of a crease there, so I'm gonna cut it out right here, crossed and down, and replace that whole top and back side. Alright, first thing we gotta do is disconnect the battery. It's not like the old school. This has the LS in it, and it is computerized, so I always unhook the computers, unhook the batteries so the computer has no connection. I learned my lesson many years ago. Any computerized vehicle, you want to disconnect the battery first. If you want to know how I learned my lesson, just ask me in the comments.
Oh, would you look at it? It's real nice. Man, aftermarket parts fit real good up in here. A little down back here. But I can pull that around. Let's see if we can't get her clamped. That big corner, so we'll just cut it about there. Same way up here. I don't want that big point. Just cut it about right there. The rest of that looks good. Yeah. Like it. Alright, I'll get those two corners cut and start taking this off. Get it all cleaned up and start undercoating. I just went around the outside and put the cutoff wheel. That'll leave my small gap to weld through. We'll get this out of the way. If you notice, even though that was straightened out, when I cut it, that sucked in. So even after you straighten stuff like that, you've still got pressure on that material. You can see down in there, you can see why that rusted out. There's a channel all the way along there. You can't get to it to undercoat or nothing. Wait till you see this. That's why it's always better to replace your panels. Sometimes you can't get in there to take care of certain things. And this is a prime example. Look at that. This thing was bed lined
I believe I bed lined everything underneath about 5 years ago. None of this was here. You could not see none of that. It looked so clean up inside. So this stuff gets in there somehow and just sits there and eats both sides inside out. So now I guess I gotta rebuild the inner lip. We'll take care of it. Dang! That thing's got some torque. Some reason my bits keep popping out. It didn't come with new bits, so and that's enough to wreck your. Alright, I'm gonna fix that. Alright, let's try this again. I put a zip tie across there to keep that down in there, but as soon as I hit the trigger, then it tried to throw the spring off, so I had to loosen the spring up. Let's see if it'll work. Yeah.
I got my piece cut. I just marked it 3/4 there, 3/4 there, because that's what the inner lip is. Traced the new repair panel. You can see that curve. I'm going to take 3/4 tape, line it on there, trim this side off, grind it up, and then I've got to put a 90 degree bend in that. So I will take you over to the brake and show you how I'm going to do that curve on the brake press. All right, I brought the pack stop in. I'll clamp that on there. Right to the center of that, I need 3/4. Right there. A small top die. Put it about right there. Yeah, it's a little narrow, but it'll be alright. Now I'll just crank this up. Alright. Now, I'll use that as my backstop. Let's see how this thing fits. Let me put my camera up so you guys can see. All right, you can see it's got a curve to it. If I had just bent that straight, it would have been clear up here and clear up here. Now it follows that contour. Now, take this and go up here like that. Right there, get that welded in. And when I go to put this panel up, just like original, plug weld around there and it'll be good as gold. Let's say. welded. All right, she's all welded to the ground. Now I'm gonna do some protection. Try to get as far up in as I can. And all the way down as low as I can. Now I put that trap on there thick. Rather it be a little thick in there than not enough. Alright, I'm gonna wait to undercoat in here until after I get the outside on, but I'm gonna let that dry out. I went ahead and got this side all cut up. Get this fit up in there. For aftermarket pieces, I'm really impressed. This side is farther down in front. This side's got some bubbling right in here. But I know I already replaced all the bottom, so that looks good. All the way around. Right there. All right, now you remember this side had one small spot and then a couple bubbles. That's the reason I wanted to remove the whole thing. See? I'm gonna do this side the same as I did the other side. Alright. I'll get this lip popped off there and I'll get a new piece made. I'm gonna clean it up a little bit better. Alright. Zip tie didn't hold, so I grabbed some heavy gauge wire. I'm gonna see if that'll do better. tell you what, if it wasn't for that, I'd really love this one. It's got some power. I don't know, I have to come up with something on that. Be nice if there was a boot around it. Get your fingers in here, man, it really kicks. But it worked really good. I don't think I showed this on the other one, but little bitty ripples. Take my flat body hammer. I like it. I am going to go ahead and cut that out there. Right at that crease. Put that up there. You're good to go. Thank you. Oh yeah, I like it. That'll work out just fine. Alright, now put the dimples in there. Finish grinding some of that bed liner off back there, and it'll be ready to weld. I'm gonna say that's tomorrow morning, and before I do that, I'm gonna start welding on the other side. Get that bed side tacked on there before I drag the welder all the way to this side. Hey, I think I've made a lot of damage. Sure wasn't expecting it, and I know he wasn't either, but I gotta make it right. It's the only way to do it. I've always said, if you're gonna do something, do it right.